It looks like a spaceship. It launches vertically, but then flies horizontally. Isn't this the coolest drone you've ever seen? Introducing the Quantix hybrid drone. Today, in partnership with AeroVironment, we're going to do some agriculture drone mapping. That's right, this bad boy has two cameras that can collect both high resolution color and multispectral imagery. We're going to use that aerial data to scout my rice fields and help determine a wide variety of crop care practices, like where do I have weed escapes? Does my crop need to be fertilized? Are insects eating my rice plants? The answer to all these questions have one thing in common: color. A quick example: chewed on rice plants are a different shade of green than full leaf healthy rice plants. In this episode, with the help of the Quantix drone, I'm looking forward to analyzing the color of my crop. I'm also going to show off the tech specs of this hybrid drone, explain how to navigate AeroVironment software, the AV decision support system, we'll log in, interpret the results, and take action. I hope in the end, if you're a farmer, no matter the crop, that this video will help you consider how you could use this technology on your farm. All that's ahead, we just need to get set up for takeoff. Now, as you just saw, the Quantix hybrid drone is easy to set up. Unload, twist on propellers, insert memory card, install battery, boot up, and we're ready to fly. So check this out on the operating tablet. We have a full pre-flight procedure. First, we select a border around the field that we want to fly. A fully automated flight path is generated. We can now see in blue the area we're mapping. Yellow is where the drone will be making its turns. The bold blue and red lines reveal both the launch and return path respectively. And it's looking good. Battery check, propeller check, wind speed check, aerospace check, final safety check, and last but definitely not least, launch. Isn't it beautiful? And as I mentioned, the Quantix drone has a vertical launch, and then at 100 feet, it transitions to a horizontal flight. This is to maximize aerodynamic efficiency and range. All this, by the way, is automatic. The launch, the flight, the data collection, and landing. Super easy to operate. For this flight, we are flying 360 feet in the air and 40 miles per hour. With the built-in dual 18 megapixel cameras, we're going to simultaneously collect high resolution color and multispectral imagery. All this will allow us to completely map and scout this 150 acre field in just 15 minutes. I tried to take some aerial shots of the drone in action with my small camera drone, but at 40 miles per hour, it was near impossible to track and film. See, here it is, and now in slow motion, real time. Could you see it? Yeah, crazy fast. Meanwhile, back on the ground monitoring the operating tablet, we can see the flight duration and mapping progress in real time. 14 minutes remaining, 10 minutes remaining, 1 minute remaining. Now let's just admire this smooth automatic landing. The cool thing is that once the drone lands, right on the tablet, you have a lower resolution quick look at your newly mapped out field. You don't even need an internet connection. You have a true color map of the field as well as an NDVI version. For those of you who don't know, that stands for Normalized Difference Vegetation Index and is a classic indicator of plant health. This quick look feature is perfect for immediate on-the-spot crop care cases that require fast decision making and action. Think of that. In 15 minutes, I can see and analyze my entire crop on 150 acres. But beyond the tablet's quick look feature, we do have access to much more advanced, higher resolution mapping and data analytics with AeroVironment's Decision Support System, or AVDSS. But for that, we'll need access to the memory card onboard the Quantix drone and our laptop. Before that though, let me explain why we flew this particular rice field and what we were looking for. Today we're addressing weed escapes, trying to determine problem areas and where we should retreat. You see, 10 days prior we treated our entire field with propanil, a contact herbicide which inhibits weeds' ability to photosynthesize. Visually, it basically burns the weeds' leaves. The unaffected rice eventually grows up above these dead or stunted weeds. Escapes are easy to spot because the weeds continue to grow, pushing up their burnt leaves above the canopy of rice. A noticeable color difference with the green rice plants contrasting against the browned weeds. If an area of weed escapes is large and potentially detrimental to our yield, we will need to retreat just that specific area, right? We're not trying to retreat the entire field. But how do we determine that specific area? Traditionally, we would need to drive around the field and from the road attempt to sketch out on a paper map the area of escapes while estimating the total acres that need to be retreated. That map would then be turned into the Ag Flying Service and a pilot from above would attempt to hit those specific spots with another dose of herbicide. As you can imagine, lots of room for error in both scouting and application. Error, of course, leading to monetary consequences, overspraying and paying for extra unneeded material, or underspraying and losing yield due to weed pressure. So you can see, from the scouting perspective, having a high-resolution color map within 15 minutes cuts down on my time driving around the field, gives me a more accurate representation of my field, and a better chance to accurately locate escapes. All in all, helping to return a greater profit on the crop. Let's take a closer look at our field with the AVDSS software. Here immediately, you can see the field we scouted for escapes. Let's look and see if the results match what my eyes saw when I first scouted the field, the traditional way, with peepers, pencil, and paper. Here within the Content Manager pop-up menu, we can select from a wide range of data analytics. Under imagery, we have the option of viewing the field as true color, enhanced color, NDVI for plant health, and GNDVI for photosynthetic activity, water and nitrogen uptake. Good news, my rice crop appears to be healthy. There are also some different layers that we can apply to this map. Canopy for indicating a particular growth stage. Looks like I have a solid stand out there. Anomaly that identifies areas of the field that differ from the norm. Let me slow down right there. Remember when I mentioned that there was noticeable color contrast between the green rice plants and browned weeds? Let's take a real good look at that anomaly layer. See here where we have those fairly large areas of bright orange? Disregard the levees, of course, but these two checks here are what I was noticing from the road and attempted to map out on paper. These areas definitely need to be retreated. What I didn't notice so well from the road were these escapes here. It looks like a lesser amount though. I may spray there too, or I may walk out into the field and take a close-up look to determine if the escapes are thick enough and confirm that the area does in fact need to be retreated. Regardless, drawing a map for the ag pilot is certainly easier and faster to do now by copying it from this monitor. Heck, I can even print these drone maps out and take them with me into the flying service. That's really awesome. I confirmed the escapes that I originally saw, but I received a more accurate mapping of their location. I was also alerted to a potential problem area that I hadn't noticed before. So how else can I see myself using the Quantix drone and AVDSS software? Like I mentioned before, scouting pests like armyworms. Their chewing on my rice plants will also create a color anomaly. After a flight, I can potentially find hot spots and treat just those specific areas. Many of you will remember my color leaf chart, which helps me determine whether or not my mid-season rice plants need additional fertilizer. But can flying my fields and analyzing the NDVI and GNDVI data help me make that determination or tell me if only specific areas need to be fertilized? And now, you can see that the rice plants have entered the reproductive phase. The rice kernels are starting to form. Can I fly my field and locate the earliest maturing portion using the anomaly layer? That would help me determine which area of the field should be harvested first. I ask, can I, and these questions, because I'm excited to find out. This is new to me. I certainly imagine all sorts of uses for the Quantix drone throughout the crop year. In the case of weed escapes, it's definitely saving me time, better informing me about my crop, and potentially saving me cash on inputs. What a useful tool to have in the toolbox. And it's my tool. AeroVironment is not selling flight services. They're selling the drone and software. That's right. This is my drone. I can fly when I want, no scheduling, no waiting. I can afford to test my ideas. I can ease into trusting and feeling confident about using the data. So, if you're a farmer like me, consider this as another tool in your toolbox that you'll carry into the future of farming. Wow, that was kind of poetic. I'm providing a link down in the description to AeroVironment's website where you can learn more. And there's a lot more to learn. Features I didn't cover, like variable rate layer that can help generate prescriptions for FMS integration in transferring data to John Deere Operations Center Connected. There's also more features like historical comparisons, quantifiable charts, and much, much more. If you have any questions for me and my experience with the Quantix hybrid drone and or the AVDSS software, please let me know down in the comments. Also, if you're a farmer and have used agriculture drone mapping in your operation, please let me know some of your experiences and some of the uses you've found for the technology. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this episode, give me a thumbs up. Otherwise, I'm going for another flight.